So we're going to start over in users and contacts. So these are the user types that we have in the system. We've got back office, branch, brokers, loan officer, contacts, and borrowers. At the top of the hierarchy is the back office user. So typically that's going to be you and your team. You're going to be back office users. And let me show you this right here. So back office users are typically going to be admin managers, processors, underwriters, closers, and you can also create custom roles. And you as back office users, you control the branches. So the branches can be looked at as sort of like your different sales channels. And your main business is always going to be under at least one branch. And you can have loan officers and brokers organized underneath that branch. Then underneath them, you'll see borrowers, and borrowers are always going to be attached to the loan files. And then if you open up another location, you have a satellite branch, you can set them up as another branch with their loan officers and brokers organized underneath that branch. And if you're working with any referral partners or correspondent networks, account executives, you can create what we call virtual branches. So if you're working with, let's say, an office of 10 brokers that want to refer business your way, you could create a branch for that office. And you can even create broker profiles for each of those brokers that are under that office. And each of those brokers can have a unique application link URL for the application. So any loan files that get submitted using that application link will come into your pipeline showing that it came from that branch and from that specific broker as well. All right. So that is the back office and the branch. The branch user is unique because the branch is also used as an organizational structure. So you're going to be organizing your branches just as we mentioned right here. But the branch also serves as a, you can give somebody a branch login as well. So if you have a branch director and you want them to be able to see everything that is going on for that specific branch only, you can create a login for that branch as well. So the person can log in, they'll be able to see just what's going on underneath that branch, but they won't be able to see what's going on in other branches. All right, so that's the branch. And then we have broker and loan officer profiles. These are very similar. These are agent profiles. And we had to call them something, so we call them broker and loan officer. But as best practice, what we recommend is if you're going to set up an external referral partner in your system, we recommend setting them up as a broker profile. And anybody who's going to be internal helping you manage the loan file, we recommend setting them up as a loan officer profile. And then we have contacts. Contacts in our system are any third-party vendors or third-party service providers. So if you have any appraisers, any title reps, any insurance agents, any attorneys, they're helpful to get into your contacts and assign them to the loan files that they're going to be working on. Because then you can take advantage of some of the automations as well. So with the system, you can actually create some predefined email templates that can go out to these different contacts at different points. So let's say you want to move the loan file from one file status to another, or from one loan stage to another, it can trigger off those automated emails to go out to these different contacts. So those are contacts. And then you have borrowers. So the borrowers, the borrower profiles are automatically created whenever somebody fills out a quick app or full apps. Maybe you sent a borrower to your website to fill out a quick app, or maybe somebody on your team went in to create a loan and filled out a quick app over here manually on behalf of a borrower. Once that loan file is created, that'll create the loan file. And at the same time, it'll also automatically create a borrower profile. You do have the ability to create borrowers one by one or import a list of borrowers, but most people just allow those borrower profiles to get automatically created whenever a new loan file is created. All right. So now let's go into the back office here. Let's go to back office lists. And we're going to take a look at creating a back office user. So just some things to be aware of when you're creating a back office user. So you're going to put in your basic information up here, email. You're going to confirm the email, employee first name, employee last name. And then you can choose whether you want to assign that user to a specific branch or branches, or you could also leave this blank. And if it's blank, it means they'll have access to all the branches. So if in the future, if right now I'm showing four branches here, but if I add a fifth branch, if I leave this blank, they'll automatically get access to that fifth branch if I create a fifth branch in the future. All right. And then you can put in your company name. But then when you get down to the role right here, this is where you want to just pay a little bit of attention when you're choosing what role you want to assign this person. So there's a lot of roles in this drop-down list. And you just want to be careful with this one right here, the one that says manager with admin rights. Whoever has access to that role is going to have access to everything in your system. They're going to have access to your settings. They'll have access to everything. So just be careful about who you assign that specific role to. All these other roles, they're just titles. So you can assign any of these. If there's a role that you would like to see on that list but doesn't exist, you could just click on this button right here and then add a new role there. And you'll be able to assign that role to that user. Then when you're creating a back office user, you're also going to want to be careful about the settings, these bottom three sections right here, the editing and visibility permissions, documents and notifications, and special reports or features sections. So if we open these up, we're going to open all three of them up. Let me move this out of the way. All right, so now we've got all three sections. So when you're creating your back office user, and this just doesn't apply to back office users, it applies to any users in the system. If you're having them log in, if you're giving them login access to use your system, you'll want to come in here and make sure you're giving the user the right level of access that you want them to have. And there's a lot of different permissions here. So you're going to want to take the time to go through all these permissions and make sure you give them the right level of permissions on some of these. And some are much more sensitive than others, right? So you can see, do you want them to be able to view commissions? Do you want them to be able to edit commissions? Would you want them to be able to copy files? Would you want them to be able to export all your file data, right? Do you want them to be able to export all your loan files? So you'll want to go through all these permissions. This is editing and visibility. Then down here, you're going to be able to choose the notifications, right? Do you want them to receive notifications when a new loan file is created? Do you want them to receive notifications when a borrower uploads documents? So you'll come in here and set all these. And then you have some special reports or features sections down below. So you can choose whether you have access to mass emailing. If you have the marketplace as part of your subscription, do you want them to be able to access the marketplace and shop the loans around? So you want to come in here and just go through all these permissions. And once you're finished setting everything correctly, go ahead and hit the save button. All right. And then when we go into the branch, we go to the branch list. You might just start off with one branch and you can add to this later. But whenever you're creating a branch, we'll go to create a branch right here. You'll be able to put in the basic information for the branch. And if you need to add a logo, you'll want to add a logo there. So having a logo is helpful for your branch. Each branch can have their own logo, which means that any loan file information that is generated, any documents that are generated from that branch can have that logo on there as well. So you want to set that as well, so each document has the information set correctly. And if you are giving someone login access as well, you don't have to, but if you are giving somebody login access, you'll want to go through all the user permissions as well. And so just a reminder, when you're giving login access to users, that's what costs an extra seat. So, you know, when we get into talking about the brokers and loan officers, you can actually create users without giving them login access. Like you can create a broker and create a broker without giving them login access, but you can still share their unique application URL with them so they can send loan files your way. And you don't have to provide them login access. And if you're not providing them login access, that's not going to cost an extra seat. So the only thing that costs an extra seat in the system is if you're providing users login access. All right. So when we're looking at the brokers here, each of the brokers has access to their own. When we go into the broker profile, and we go to the web form integration tab for the borrower, this is where we're going to see these application links. And these are unique to the specific broker profile that we're in right now. So we wouldn't want to share these links with anybody else other than the specific broker that we're currently in right now, this broker right here. So you'll have access to all that information there. And just like the branch, each branch has their own web form integration tab. So each branch is going to have their own application links as well. But these are like company application links, right? So if I go into this branch right here and I go to the web form integration tab for that branch, this is where I'm going to have access to all the application links for this branch. All right. Just like on the broker profile level, you'll have access to the broker application links. Any of the links that are used from the broker application web form integration tab, those are going to come in organized under the branch that that broker belongs to, and it'll show that it came from that broker. These company branch links, these are not going to show that it came from a broker. These are just going to show that it came from a branch. Okay. And then you have a broker loan officer, same thing with a loan officer. If you go into the loan officer list and we go into their profile, they're not going to have the web form integration tab. That's going to be done through the broker profiles, but you can come in here and make your edits to the loan officer profiles. If you need to create a new loan officer, you'll be able to do so. And then just like with any of the other users, when you're giving them login access, you're going to want to make sure you go into the user settings and set the correct level of permissions for each user. Some of these permissions may not show up if you don't have the login turned on. So once you turn on the login and you save this user, if you go back into their profile, that's when all the permissions will show up. All right, so this user right now that we're looking at, right here, what says allowed to log in, this is turned off right now. And that's why we're not seeing any options under these user permission settings. Okay. And then you have the contacts and the borrowers. So that's pretty much the users right there.